This is a 3D printer. Doesn't look like much, but little by little, it lays down razor-thin layers of plastic to make. Well, leave it to your imagination. We found an appealing example in a shop in Old Town Florissant called Posy Pots and 3D Prints. The core products offered by owner Kay Wells are eye-catching, sturdy, self-watering flower pots, manufactured with 3D printing from Wells' own patented designs.
You put your water through a feeding tube that I created. You put your water on top, and it actually trickles down to the bottom where there's a reservoir in the bottom. And all of this was created on the 3D printer. Actually, I put it into the computer first. So computer-aided drafting or CAD modeling system. You have your drainage and aeration, and you cannot overfill it. There's a drain hole in the back. And then you have your reservoir at the bottom. With all of that, you only have to water your plant once a month.
Wells's Posy Pots became so popular, her 3D printers weren't enough to fulfill the large contracts coming her way in a timely manner. So she decided to outsource some of the manufacturing.
Someone referred me to them. They said, hey, these guys are opening up their new shop on Del Mar. They said, come on by, and they had their 3D printing line running. I explained to them what I was doing and what I was trying to bring with the sustainable agriculture, with green energy. So it was just really a perfect match.
Kay Wells is a client of the St. Louis 3D printing company, Printerior. It's located in that building across the street in the city's Makers District. In 2021, Printerior was awarded an ARCH grant for its process of creating objects from recyclable plastic. Its sustainable practices result in zero waste. Printerior co-founders Trent Esser and Hayden Seidel.
We both had wanted to start a company together for quite a while. Hayden really got into 3D printing while we were in college, and I had a background in sustainability. And Mizzou had actually just launched a new program called EQ, which was their entrepreneurship accelerator program. And so we had actually just come up with this idea, just heard about the accelerator program, and we basically came up with the whole thing in about 2 weeks and pitched it to the pitch competition, and we ended up getting in. And so then we really had to flush everything out. We had a lot of pivots along the way, a lot of changes of how we wanted to do things, but they all kind of brought us here.
Examples of Esser's and Seidel's work are all over their facility and shared on Printerior's popular social media accounts. And yes, the Olympic rings are 3D printed too. If there's a need for a particular object for their operation, they'll just make it.
So we needed a new light switch. That was an easy 3D print. Our whole shipping desk needed to be completely organized because it was a mess. So everything on there that is attachment-wise, from paper holders to sticker holders to tape holders, they're all 3D printed. We have done sculptures for ourselves that are our own sign that is going in the front of our building is 3D printed.
Our extrusion line, we 3D printed bearings and different gears to help dial in our extrusion line. We've got different brackets for shelving systems.
Our business card holders.
They also make what is wrapped around these spools. This is filament, which is to 3D printing what paper is to inkjet printing. Printerior sells filament to businesses that do their own printing and to 3D printing hobbyists. We wanted to see how filament is made, so we returned to Printerior a few weeks later when a large order was being filled. The process starts with recycled plastic in the form of pellets, or in this case, flakes.
And then right behind you, Ruth, we have a mixer, which mixes all of the material if you want to change the color. So today we're just doing the natural blue, so we don't need to add any colorant.
The plastic is loaded into the hopper, where it's dried, and emptied into the extruder, which melts it. The liquefied plastic is pushed out in a form resembling the finished filament and flows through a two-stage water bath to gradually cool. Then it's pulled into an overhead storage area until it's time to run it through the spooler.
Looking pretty good.
The spools themselves are made of recycled cardboard.
All this scrap can go to our recycling bins.
And that's the super simplified explanation of a process where precision is everything. The final stop for filament is a 3D printer, where it's melted down one more time. The printer is programmed to create an object from a design made on a computer and saved as a digital file.
And the way that it works is it lays down every layer over and over and over again, just like a traditional printer, but it builds it up into a 3D object. It's a circular solution of from starting with raw material to making filament to printing things to recycling things. So we tried to really bring a circular aspect to the business.
Printerior's owners say they're starting small but hope to make a big impact, an attitude shared by client Kay Wells, who describes the potential of the 3D printing industry as ginormous.
3D printing is really the wave of the future, and I'm here for it.
For Living St. Louis, I'm Ruth Ezell.